वेलकम टू बीजेटी। रिसोर्सेज यू विल नीड।
टुडे इज द लास्ट ट्यूटोरियल इन द बीजेटी आईओटी सीरीज। सो टुडे वी विल लर्न अ कंप्लीट ऑटोमेशन इन टू मोड्स। वन इज ऑटोमेटिक कंप्लीटली सेंसर बेस्ड, अनदर इज मैनुअल। सो प्लीज पे अटेंशन, इट मे टेक लॉन्गर देन यूजुअल। एज पर द प्रीवियस, हियर वी आर यूजिंग एलडीआर सेंसर। वी आर क्रिएटिंग एलडीआर वैल्यू एज अ फीड। We are using LED, so LED feed is there and another is mode. So there are three feeds. So first the sensor value that is going to publish, and the lamp signal and the mode, these two are subscribed. That means we are sending the value, only the LDR value, and we are receiving two value. One is lamp, another is mode. So lamp pin is connected to pin number 5, LDR is connected to analog, and one is LDR, another is thing is mode. So we have mentioned the pin, lamp pin is the output pin, and rest things are same. Here do not forget to make these pins as a subscribe pin. MQTT subscribe, address of lamp and address of mode, underscore M, underscore A, that is manual, underscore automatic. Then MQTT connect has been called here, publish send and publish receive. So we will focus on the publish send and publish receive. Almost these are same as the previous one. Now what I checked, the LDR value having condition that LDR value less than 501, then turn on the LED or the lamp, otherwise turn it off. So it is based on the LDR. So we are doing automatic things here. But in the outer loop condition, if you check MD is equals to auto, that means it is auto, then we have to do this. Otherwise we are going to into the subscribe section, and here we will check if mode is equals to manual. Then if match is equals to on, then you have to turn on the LED, otherwise make it off. So let's check it out via Adafruit IO. So first we have to create lamp feed. Lamp is already there, we will not make it again. LDR value, create new feed, LDR value, mode feed, create new feed. Now create a new dashboard, manual auto mode automation. Here first we will have toggle mode, that is mode. Next one is manual, another is auto. Create a block, create another block, toggle associate with lamp. Next give the name lamp control. Create a new block, gauge, associate with LDR value, and set the maximum limit to 1024. Create a block, create indicator, associate with LDR value, and put the condition less than 501, that has been mentioned same in the code section. Now let's arrange these. Here it is mode, one is manual, another is auto. Status indicator looks better. Save. If you focus at the circuit diagram, it is simple. In this case we have created LDR sensor connected on analog pin and symbolic LED at pin number D1, so it doesn't require any extra power or resources. If we remove this and connect the home appliances, then how it would change? When you connect the home appliances, it requires 220 volt of AC power. And look back to the Arduino tutorials, how do we connect via relay module? So it will go into the relay, and relay requires its own power, and the input of this will be taken from D1. Fine, so it will control the switching of the home appliances. Upload the sketch. Done uploading. Now remove the power. And make the circuit. LED we use directly. Then sensor, one point to the VCC, another point to the ground, and output from this to analog pin. Now we can turn on the power as well as we can connect the USB. So let me turn on the power. connect the USB and go to the Adafruit. Here symbolically we have used LED. You can replace with the home appliances also. Refer the previous tutorial from BJT Arduino series, and here I will show you. It is on the auto mode, and first we will try to manual mode. So in the manual mode it should be turned on. It takes 6 seconds. Now it can be turned on, sorry, off. It can be turned off and on again. But when I switch to auto mode, then if I try to change it, it will not get done. Just check it out. If I try to put it on, it is not working. If I will try to put it off, not working. Because it is in the auto mode now. So in the auto mode, we have set down the condition that when we put darkness to the sensor, then the value goes down below 500, then it will turn it on. So status indicator has been green in the screen, as well as LED has been glow here. So you can check it out. Now if I remove it, so status indicator shows value is 1024 and LED is off. So status indicator, you can check it out. So in this way you can automate anything with various kind of sensor as well as values. Thank you guys. So till this point we have done with the BJT IoT series. If you want something else, please put down your comments or ask via mail or website.
Please comment, like and subscribe.